Good morning, Mount Olive. I hope everyone has had a great week. Let's begin with a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you now for this day. We thank you, Lord, for letting us come. Lord, I pray now that all is well, everything is good. I pray, Lord, now for the members of Mount Olive that you watch over us, keep us. I plead the blood of Jesus upon us, our households. And Lord, I pray that we'll all stay, remain safe, and we'll still look to you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I hope all is well today. Today I am at Rose Chapel's basketball court. I've tried to say I want to try to mix things up and do a little things a little different. Also remember that you can still give online at www.mountolivenoonan.com. So you'll be able to still give online. We will also still have our Zoom meeting at 12:15. At 12:15, we'll still have our Zoom meeting, and you should be getting your Bible study material to be prepared for it. I just want to take 1 minute to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers that are out there. I know usually, Mount Olive, on this day, we will have Emily passing out stuff for the mothers, and we would come up, but lo and behold, it wasn't the good Lord's will for it this Sunday. So, I begin my message today. I want to use a very familiar passage, one of my favorite passages in the Bible, Micah, the 7th chapter in the 8th verse. Do not gloat over me, my enemy. Though I have fallen, I will rise. Though I sit in darkness, the Lord will be my light. Micah at the time was in a troublesome period. His enemies was gloating over him. I want to use the topic this morning, I would use breaking the press. Micah was at a spot. He was at a spot to where people were gloating on him. They were in captive. The people were gloating over him. You know, doesn't it seem like when we're down, people will gloat over us? But church, I'm here today on a basketball court. And I wanted to talk a little bit about how the enemy right now is gloating over us. I want to think about how the devil is laughing right now because we're not in church. But though he's gloating, we're still, the gospel's still going out, the message is still spreading. So I want to talk about, it's like today we're in a full court press. You know, in basketball, when you try a full court press, you're basically trying to steal the ball. One of the things they told me when I was playing basketball, or when I seen Dooney and Cortland all playing basketball, and I heard the coaches tell them, when you got a press coming, when the first thing you come in, stay calm. Stay calm, church. Even though the devil is attacking us now, he's coming against us, I want to tell you, stay calm. If you're playing basketball and you get pressed, the worst thing you can do is panic. If you panic, you just want to just try to hurry and get the ball out your hand. But if you stay calm. The other Sunday when we talked about, when I had the fire chief with the message, the same thing, when you're in a fire, you stay calm. The thing of it in church, we can't let anxiety drive us. We can't let fear drive us. We can't let worry drive us. During this time, stay calm. Though we're not at church, though some of us might not be at work, some of us could be working at home, some of us could still have to go to work, I will tell you to everyone out there that's listening, when the press come and the devil is pressing us right now, I will tell you to stay calm. Stay calm. Also, Mount Olive, before the end of this video, I will dunk this basketball. I will dunk it. And I'm going to remain calm. So at the end of the video, you will see me dunk this basketball. Next thing we have to do, with full court press, you got to attack. You got to attack. You're thinking of it, so how do we attack? We attack by praying every day. We attack by praying to God to give us strength. We attack with the Word of God. You see, if I try to attack with my own flesh, I'm going to fall short. I'm not going to make it. I'm going to eventually get tired. I don't know about you, but you get tired, worn out, back's going to hurt, knee's going to hurt. But church, we still got to attack. We could be on the offensive with prayer. Are you praying every day for God's strength? Are you praying for God to get you through? Continue to pray. Continue to lift everything up in prayer. When worry comes, pray. When the struggle comes, pray. When doubt comes, pray. When fear comes, pray. Continuously attack. Nextly, what do we have to do? You got to first stay calm. You got to attack. But first of all, when you're on the basketball court, you got to look. You got to look. One thing, if you're down in the post, you're going to look to the side, but also you're going to look up. Right now, church, I'm looking unto the hills, which cometh all my help. I'm going to keep looking. I'm going to look up because I know this. God is greater than this. Micah, one of the part of the text I want you to focus on. He said, though I sit in darkness. Church, you notice he didn't say, though I lie in darkness. He said, I sit. When you sit somewhere, your intention is to get up eventually. I'll sit in my chair, sit in my car, but I eventually have to do what? I have to get up. Micah was sitting in darkness, but he has so much confidence that even though the devil was pressing him in full court pressing, that guess what? He knew he wasn't going to stay there. Church, we're not going to stay here. We're not going to continue to be meeting like this. This might be the norm for the minute, but guess what? The word is going forth. The gospel is going forth. Right now, the greatest evangelical digital evangelism that has ever gone to the church. We're utilizing, but we're not going to continue to sit in darkness. We're going to be like Micah. Though we're sitting here, we know we will rise. We know we will get up. So church, when you look, you've got to look at when you break the press. When you break the press, usually what happens, if they're trying to trap your pressure, usually somebody can usually turn around, you look at somebody underneath the goal, and you get a layup, but I missed. But like anything in life, guess what? I rebounded. In life, you might miss the shot, but guess what? God, we will rebound, and after you rebound, rebound again. Then you can make the shot. Church, now you notice I said I'm going to dunk. I am going to dunk this basketball, but not at that goal. You know, during this time, church, we can't lower our standards, lower what God expects. I said I was going to dunk, and I did. But what did I have to do to dunk? Do you show that goal? Show this goal. I had to lower the standard. Church, God will never lower his standards. So why should we lower our standards? Is there a greater feeling of dunking off a 10-foot goal versus dunking off a 6-foot goal? Church, during this day, don't lower your standards. Don't lower who you are in the Lord. Continue to lift God up, and you'll be able to dunk, not just on this goal or that goal, but you will be able to spiritually dunk on any goal. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you now for this day. We thank you, Lord, for letting us come. Lord, Micah was at a point where people were gloating over him, and I know now some people are gloating over us. But Lord, we know right now that you are greater than any threat that the devil has thrown. Though we're sitting in darkness, we know we will rise again. We will rise as the church. We will rise as a body. And Lord, we just thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, church, I know I'm going to hear it about missing the two layups, but I hadn't practiced in a while. But church, here's the thing. Let us not lower the standard. And when the devil comes with his full court press, let us stay calm, let us attack, and let us look. And then you will get the easy layup. Until next week, church, I'll see you at 12:15 on Zoom. Amen.